Oh, you see, but we're open wide. I did not believe my eyes. He was a teeny tiny spot on the floor.
It's 11:20 exactly, and as promised, I'm just going to get this going here because we have this little bed. I think the first one begins with, come on now, Betsy. I have to coax the, it's like, please, please, Miss Nona Hendryx.
Way back then.
Yeah. Yes. I remember dancing to this.
Okay. Great. It was good to dance to.
It was excellent. Yeah. Excellent. Miss Nona Hendryx, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you. Thank you so much for...
You're a nightbird.
It's, yes.
Yes.
And it's taken a lot of, how can I say... coordination to get this moment to finally happen.
Yes.
Actually, over a couple of years, too. Because
Has it been that long?
Well, I bumped into you and like, hi, you know, I have a show. And you're like, oh, well, here's my card. And then I would sort of lose the card. And I would ask someone, do you know how I can contact her? Like, and then I would bump into you again. It's some, I think I last bumped into you at, I can't remember. But anyway.
Something.
And, and so now it's happened.
Yes.
So thank you so much. And
you're
I know
welcome.
You have an early morning. And I'm,
yes, I do.
I'm so glad you're here.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
So what initially, I guess what's really finally made this happen is you have, I guess I want you to explain how HopeStock has come about. Are, are you the founding member? Did HopeStock reach out to you? I mean, everyone knows you from the days of Patti LaBelle and the Bluebells,
yes,
and then LaBelle, and then you, Nona Hendryx, the solo artist, and just illustrious career. But now you're a philanthropist of some sort. So maybe I'll just let you sort of, should we go backwards from HopeStock, and we'll start with HopeStock.
Yeah, no, that's a good place to start because that's currently what I'm involved in, among other things, my own solo career. But... working with one of the artists who is one of the members of HopeStock, the collective, Giuseppe Spolatini, who is a classically trained singer, baritone. And interestingly, he wanted to make a inspirational, traditional gospel record.
Yeah.
Because he discovered gospel music.
Wow.
And...
is he Italian?
He's Italian. He's Canadian. Italian.
Right.
And from Calgary. And he wanted to make this record, and a friend of mine who he's working with wanted to support him in doing it. And so he made the record. And of course, you know, once they made the record, it's like, well, what do we do with it? It's like,
right.
Well, if you don't know what to do, you need help. So they asked me to help, and I became more involved. And in doing so, looking at, you know, different artists and how it's so difficult to build an audience when you're new, and after your family and your close friends come to see you, who's going to come see you?
Well, I would add to that, in addition to that, also, if you're an artist that is not, doesn't fit into the
yes.
three boxes of
yes.
Western music, you
yes.
know, pop, rock, soul, R&B, yes. that's it. You know, if you're in any way a unique sound, mm-hmm. they just don't know what to do with you, and they hence don't do anything with you.
Yes,
so,
exactly.
So that seems like that was part of his issue as well. If he yeah. was sort of like a classically trained gospel singer.
Yes. Well, and, I mean, it's an unusual pairing of a genre and a singer. Mm-hmm. And then you couldn't really be in the gospel world because that's pretty much considered a black domain.
Yes.
And then the Christian side has become really rock, Christian rock.
Yeah, yeah,
and
yeah.
And so it was very difficult. And so having that problem to solve, this young man who was working with me and is working with us in HopeStock, Joe Germalvo, I brought Joe on to help me with some of the concerts we were doing for Giuseppe. And then there was another friend, Christian Wakane, who is a journalist and was writing for online magazines and blogs. And Christian was working with another artist who was having a similar problem in his life. So, you know, you look around and you can find quite a few artists who are having that kind of problem.
Sure,
and
sure.
I wanted to introduce Joe and Christian so that they could maybe solve their problem together. And in doing so, Christian brought Lindsay Wilson. And
yes,
then
sitting quietly in the
yes.
corner. I don't think she's usually quiet, I would suspect. I don't know her very well, but...
no, she's fairly quiet, but
okay.
But when she has something, she says it.